Hi, this is Sahana. In this video, we are going to understand HTTP GET request in the context of ASP.NET Core Web API. As you might already know, Web APIs use the HTTP as their primary means of communication over the internet. HTTP defines several methods, and we call these methods as HTTP verbs. HTTP verbs or methods indicate desired action to be performed on a resource, and they provide a standardized way for clients to interact with the server resources. Here are the commonly used HTTP verbs. They are GET, POST, PUT, PATCH, and DELETE. HTTP GET method is used to retrieve data from a server. When you send GET request to a server, it typically includes data in URL's query string. Let's say you want to request a specified resource, you want to pass ID, then GET request will include that ID in URL's query string. This is our web API application. We have to do controller and get all action method. As we have already discussed, when a request reaches this application, this controller, todo controller, will receive the request and it will decide which action method is going to handle that request. And it will check what type of request it has received. If it is GET request, then todo controller will assign that responsibility to this GET all method. Because if you look at this attribute, we have specified HTTP GET. If we use this attribute, this indicates that this action method supports HTTP GET method. Before proceeding further, I would like to make few changes to this code. If you look at this code, here we are using todo item, which is a model. In real code, this model, there will be two types of models. One is a domain model, which will be used by a database, and other type of model, we call that type of model as data transfer objects, DTOs, that we use to transfer data to the client. DTO, which stands for Data Transfer Object, is the most common and safe way to expose data in a web API. If you have worked on web application, we use view models. DTO is nothing but view model. As it is a web API application, we call this as Data Transfer Object. We use this approach to avoid unnecessary exposure of details to the client. This is our private method, which maps todo item model to todo item DTO. Here we have written a mapping. Next, let's map todo item objects to todo item DTO objects. I will declare our variable. Now, let's take this list. Then, we are going to select item such that. Next, we are going to call this. We are going to call this method, and we are going to pass this item. So this way we are going to convert. Then we are going to convert this. This way our todo item DTOs list is ready. Instead of this todo item list, we are going to return this list to the client. Let's run this web API. This web API exposes single endpoint that handles HTTP GET request. Okay, if you want to execute this endpoint through this Swagger UI, just click on try it out. Now, you can click on this execute. Here you can see that this web API has returned a response. This is the response body. Web API returns the code 200. That means the response is a success response. Here you can also see the code description. Here, 200 means success. As we have discussed earlier, HTTP GET method is used to retrieve data from a server. This method has returned all the todo items. Look at this web API. Here we have GET all method, which handles HTTP GET request. And this method returns all the todo items. Here we have defined all the todo items. This is our test data. And here, this application, as of now, it is not connecting to database. Here we have prepared sample data, and this get all method is preparing this sample data, which is a list of todo items. Right now, we have only one action method, which retrieves all todo items. Let's add one more action method, which handles HTTP GET request. And let's see how to pass particular ID and retrieve particular to-do item. Now, let's add one more action method. Let's copy this. Not have this to-do item by ID. This is going to be our action method. And this action method is going to handle HTTP GET request. Let's add HTTP GET attribute to this action method. This HTTP GET attribute specifies that this action method handles HTTP GET request. In this case, we want to send route parameter and we want to receive that parameter and use it in our filter. In that case, we have an option to specify placeholder. If you want to specify placeholder, then just specify the name of the parameter. Here, I'm going to name it as ID and I will pass int ID to this and I will modify this method to receive integer type ID parameter. One thing that you should remember is here this parameter name and the parameter name specified in the HTTP GET attribute and the parameter name specified in the action method should match. Here, both are matching with each other. Now we are going to write logic to retrieve to-do item by ID. See, here we are checking if the to-do items count is 0. If it is 0, we are going to return not found. Even here, we want to make the same check. Now we are going to fetch to-do item by ID. If everything is okay, then we are going to map to-do item to to-do item DTU by calling this private method. Here we have this private method and we are returning okay with to-do item DTU. So this is our logic to return to-do item by ID. Let's verify this now. This is the Swagger UI. Here you can see this to-do API has two endpoints. Both are capable of handling HTTP GET request. This one returns all to-do items and this one takes ID as parameter. Let's try it out. Now I'll pass one as ID and I will execute this. See, Web API has returned this response. Here you can see ID 1 is matching with the parameter that we have passed. Let's keep breakpoint here and understand the mapping. Okay, let's try it out and let's click on execute. Here we have a control. You can see that ID, we are able to map ID to this ID parameter. Let's try with some other ID. We execute. See, we have passed ID as 3, but if you look at this data, we don't have matching record. This time it should return not found. Continue. See, we have a response saying not found and status is 404. This is how we can handle HTTP GET request in our web API. This session is all about handling HTTP GET request. In our upcoming session, we are going to understand how to handle HTTP POST request in detail. Thanks for your time. See you soon in the next video. Thank you.